Hello student, back again. Viola DVD-9, page 28, sound innovation, book 1. Alright. Now, read the theory, top of your page, which is 28, in a bracket, so called slur. It's a little like a tight, the little line conjunctum in the next notes, okay? But not the same notes, maybe the same, or maybe a little bit different notes. That's mean you play that with the same bow. Like example, I play over here, you play the D and the E, like. The same bow. Okay, now exercise 105. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2. 1, 2. Good, with a slur. Okay, so exercise 106, page 28. Let's play that. 3, 4. Do it again. So what are you gonna do? You slur a little bit higher and bit farther from your D. Okay, do it again. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, now 107. Okay, slur again. 1, 2, 3. So look at which one is your highest notes over here. That third finger, third dot on a A string, which is D, right? One. So almost you play. We're playing the D major scale with slur. Okay, 107. Page 28. 1, 2, 3, 4. Next bracket, which is called the hooked bow. What does that mean? You play two notes, like this time is with the tight and the staccato, and stop it, okay? Stop between like that. Like tight, but you go staccato, you stop between notes, right? Okay, good. 108. Okay, let's play 108. So, what are you going to do here? Play the hooked bow on an A string, third finger, third dots, okay? Okay, so the next bar is your second finger on an A string, right? Which is C sharp, and back to the next bar, back to D and C sharp and D and B and C sharp and D, okay? So 108, 1, 2, 3, 4. 3, 4. 3, 4. Good. 109. Also hooked bow, but with slur. Hooked bow and with slur. 1, 2, 3, 4. Again. So which one is the highest note? It's a D, right? Now in the first bar, your first is two slur, right? and then you have hook above is an open A. Okay, so do it again, 109, slowly. Good, excellent. 110, it's a little song with slur, with hook and bow. Ready? So have a look which one is your highest notes here. Which is, I can see on the highest notes on the second line, the second line, last bar, which is D. Okay, D on the third finger, third dot. And then also, okay, now play that slowly. And the key signature is D major, which is you have F sharp and C sharp, plus the time signature is 3-4. What does that mean? 3 beat at the bar, so 3 quarter notes, or 1 minimum and quarter notes, or dotted minimum, or 6 eighth notes, okay? Ready? So play at beginning. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so that's how you play with the stuck with the hooked bow. Okay, so play the first bar only. First bar only. Good. All right, play the one to the third bar. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so one bow. Do it again, third bar. Again, 1, 2, 3. Good. If you can use the fourth finger, fine. You play with the fourth finger now. 1, 2, 3. Good. The third bar. All right. Play the second line, second bar. Okay. 1, 2, 3. Again, 1, 2, 3. Good. Play the second line, first bar. Okay? 1, 2, 3. With an open A. You can play the fourth one. It's just better if you play the open A. So the first line, first bar. 1, 2, 3. Again, 3, 1, 2, 3. Good. Alright, now play the whole song slowly. 110. 1, 2, 3, 4. Good. Play it again slowly. 1, 2, 3. Good. Play the last two bars again. 110. Okay. 110, second line, last two bars, okay? 1, 2, 3. Good, all right. Now, next page, page 29. Read the brackets, your theory, common time. It's like a capital C, when you see that on your beginning of your line. Capital C, that's mean 4-4, common time. You don't have to. Sometimes you can't see the numbers like 4-4, just play that capital C, that means naturally is over, naturally is 4-4, which is 4 beat per bar. Okay, and see here, see the next one is semitone, which is a half notes each other, half far, the notes each other. The next one is tone, which is one note, like example D, E. And the semitone half notes F or F sharp G. okay? F sharp G, only half notes, which is when you see in a piano, F sharp, it's a black key, and the next to is the G, is a white key. And in a piano, like D, E, is two white keys near each other, okay? All right. It's good to check out in a piano anyway. And if it's not, just keep playing a scale. All right, let's play a scale. 111, okay, page 29. Let's see. Start on D and after you go up to, and watch at which is a whole note and which one is a half note. In a D major or any major scales, the third to the fourth note is a semitone, which is half notes, and the seventh and an eighth, which is up. Seven and eight notes between, it's seven and eight notes is a semitone. Only other notes is a tone. Okay, so like, okay, play 1-1-1, which is 111. 1, 2, 3, 4. Semitone. Tone. Semitone. So tone, tone, semitone, tone, tone, semitone, okay? All right, 112, play with the slur. So we're using now D and the A string, okay? So which one is the highest note over here? Like is the last bar of that line, okay, which is D, all right. So don't forget, it's going to be jump, it's a bit higher, okay? 1, 2, 3, 4, common time, when you see that C, capital C, when after the hashtags, next to the hashtags, is a capital C, which is common time, is 4-4. So 112. 1, 2, 3, 4. Exercise 113. 1, 2, 3, 4. Do it again slowly. 1, 2, 3, 4. Over here, basically you go up by notes and keeping the A. It's like 1, 2, 3. Okay, like slur. You basically you're practicing slur. All right, 114. Theme from the Beethoven, and you just before that learn that little bracket, it's a concerto mean. It's a little composition for orchestra and soloist by like Ludwig van Beethoven wrote a lot of concerto. Like that's the name of that. Sometimes concerto is smaller than and shorter than the symphony. Okay? The symphony is a pretty long piece. Concerto a little bit shorter. Okay, all right. Usually concerto has the orchestra and the soloist. Like a soloist, like a violin player, and stand up and play, and the concerto, orchestra accompany the violin player. That's what it is. All right. Okay, so exercise 114, page 29. So have a look. What is over here? Which one is your higher notes? Like a second bar, you have also three. Third finger. Okay. So what is that? D, right? D. This is a higher note. And you have slur. And then also you have your repeating sign between 1, 2, 3 and the fourth line. Fourth bar you're repeating back to 1, and the second time when you come, you skip the first bracket and then you go to the second one, which is the last two bars. Okay, let's play slowly. First notes, always look at the first notes and sometimes the last notes of the song. The first notes, what is this? Second finger of your D string, which is F sharp. Okay? Okay? On a G string, which one is the second dots? B. Alright? On a D string, F sharp. And the third one is D, G. You check with the open string. Alright. So start the second finger on your G, D string. Exercise 1, 2, 3, 4. The last two bars on an A string. That's the last two bars, the second bracket, okay? So play that again, which is D, G, E, open A, or four finger, open D. So that's the last two bars. Play it again, slowly. 1, 2, 3, 4. Repeat. Last two bars. Last bar again. Again, last two bars. Play the whole song again. 1, 2, 3, 4. Repeat. Good. Now I need a little bit of rosin because squeaking. When you hear the squeaking sound, you need to put some rosin in it. Anyway, I'll play the next song, so that's alright. We put up with the squeaking a little bit. Okay, the 150 exercise 115. Okay, and it's look at your key signature. Key signature 1 sharp, which is G major. Okay, G major. Alright, so what about the time signature? 3-4, what does that mean? And also the pickup, you start with ta-da-ta. So how many beats in a bar? 3. So which one is the higher note over here? D, right? Third finger on your... Third finger on your A string. Ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Okay, that's good. All right, now do it. Do it. So play it slowly. One, two. DVD. Bye.